Thank you for agreeing to participate in a Quality Matters peer review at Cincinnati State. Before you get started, I would like to briefly explain the QM review process and your role as a subject matter expert. This tutorial will help you understand the Quality Matters review process, the rubric and scoring, how to review learning objectives, how to check for alignment, and how to give helpful recommendations. Quality Matters is an internationally known program for quality assurance in online education. An important part of QM is the Quality Matters review, which is based on these four principles. The QM review process is continuous in that it is designed to assure that every course will eventually meet expectations. It is centered on research, student learning, and quality. The peer review process is faculty-driven and expected to be diagnostic and collegial, never evaluative or judgmental. And the review is based on collaboratively found evidence in the course, not on the personal preferences of the reviewer. At Cincinnati State, each online course is reviewed by two faculty members. You have been invited into the process by your dean because he or she considers you to be a responsible and thorough team worker. As a subject matter expert on the team, your understanding of the discipline and of the expectations for learning in the course are critical for determining if the class materials and assessments are in alignment with the stated learning objectives, but more on that later. A Quality Matters review is done with reference to a rubric of quality standards. The QM rubric is divided into 8 general standards. You will only be scoring Standard 1 and parts of Standards 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. The subject matter expert portion of the rubric is included in the packet you have been sent. Within the 8 general standards are 43 specific review standards. In order for a course to meet expectations, it must meet all of the 3-point essential standards and receive a total score of 84 out of the possible 99 points. We never use the words pass or fail in a QM review. A standard is either met or not yet met, and every course is expected to eventually meet Quality Matters expectations. You are only asked to review 15 of the specific review standards, but they are very important. Those are standards 1.1 through 1.9, and 2.1, 2.2, 3.1, 4.1, 5.1, and 6.1. For guidance in how each standard should be reviewed, QM publishes annotations to go with the rubric. You will find the annotations you need on pages 4 through 7 of your packet. Standards 2 through 6 are alignment standards and must be carefully assessed to make sure that all of the pieces fit together. When a course is aligned, students will know what skills they are expected to develop, how the teaching and learning activities will help them achieve the skills, and how they will be evaluated on those skills. Each standard should be evaluated carefully and commented upon. Your comments will show the course developer why you have assessed the standard to be met or not yet met. When scoring each standard, you will go by an 85% rule. In other words, you will determine if the standard has been met 85% of the way or above. We are looking for a B+ or better. Despite the specificity of the annotations, QM reviews are somewhat subjective. Although none of us likes grade inflation, there is a little wiggle room, and perfection is not required for a standard to meet. As a peer, you will put on your teacher hat when deciding if the standard is met at a B+ or A level. If you determine the course meets a standard at 85% or higher, you will give the full points possible for that standard. If not, you will write pending in the points space. There are no partial points given. In addition, you will give feedback and the course developer will take your comments into consideration and determine the best way to meet the standard. One of the most important roles a subject matter expert plays in the process is to check for alignment between the course learning objectives, module or unit learning objectives, instructional materials, course activities, and assessments. All of the alignment standards are worth 3 points and considered essential. In an online course, each unit or module will have learning objectives that support the course-level learning objectives or outcomes. Before alignment can be determined, the course and module learning objectives must be both measurable and in alignment with each other. In the following section of this tutorial, I will discuss measurability and alignment. Please note, if the course is a TAG or CTAG course, the learning objectives cannot be changed, even, unfortunately, if they are not measurable. Specific Review Standard 3.1 accounts for this and states that if the objectives or competencies are institutionally mandated, consider the module unit objectives or competencies to assess whether the course meets Standard 3.1. A good first step to checking the learning objectives is to copy and paste all of them into a Word document so you can see the course level and module level objectives in one place. And by the way, if the course does not have module level learning objectives, the review must be halted and the course developer will be asked to add them before the review can continue. Measurable objectives use strong verbs to describe what the students will be able to do at the end of the unit and ultimately the course. In this example, the verbs identify and describe clearly state what the students should be able to do at the end of the unit on motherboards. Objectives that aren't measurable and say things like "will understand how a motherboard works" are too vague and don't clearly describe what the students should know. They also fail to adequately steer the instruction and assessment in the course. In order to determine if learning objectives are measurable and in alignment, we refer to Bloom's Taxonomy of Cognitive Learning. You have a copy of this chart on page 8 in the subject matter expert packet that you received. According to this taxonomy, the most basic levels of learning are in the lowest domain and are foundational for increasing levels of complexity. As a subject matter expert, we rely on you to determine if the course materials and assessments are appropriate for the cognitive learning domains indicated in the course and module learning objectives. Page 9 in your packet is a list of sample action verbs that match the Bloom's cognitive levels. You might refer to this list if you are unsure of a learning objective. Once you have assured the learning objectives are measurable and aligned from course level to module level, you will determine if the assessments, instructional materials, learning activities, and course technologies support the objectives and match the Bloom's cognitive domains expressed in the objectives. This is what we mean by alignment. Pages 10 and 11 in your packet give an example of how a physics course's instructional materials, activities, and assessments align with the learning objectives. For Standard 3.1, you will look at the assessments to make sure they align, in that they assess the student's achievement of at least one learning objective. In other words, If a learning objective says students will be able to analyze something, there should be an assessment in which they show that they are able to do the analysis. Likewise, there should be no empty assessments. Assessments that require students perform skills that aren't stated in the learning objectives. After checking for alignment between the objectives and the assessments, you will want to make sure the instructional materials, such as texts, videos, and lectures, and the activities that offer hands-on practice, align with the learning objectives. It is important that instructional materials and activities prepare the students for success on the assessments. You will also decide if the course technology, such as the use of discussion boards, blogs, or web conferencing, support the students' achievement of the learning objectives. If a standard is not met at 85% or higher, you will score it as pending and are required to give feedback that will help the developer make revisions in order to meet QM standards. Of course, we hope you will give feedback on all of the standards, whether or not they meet expectations, since QM operates under the presumption that all courses can be improved upon, even those that meet QM standards. This diagram illustrates a helpful recommendation. You will refer to the standard at hand, quote or paraphrase the part of the annotation that applies to your comment, mention specific evidence from the course, and always maintain a positive tone that is sensitive to your peer. Your suggestions will be specific and measurable so the developer can understand what you mean. Helpful recommendations are specific in that they both cite the annotation and identify what is found in the course, and they're constructive in that they advise on how the standard can be met. Most importantly, a helpful recommendation recognizes what the developer has done well and is written in a positive and collegial tone. If any of the alignment standards are not met, take some time to offer a variety of solutions. Sometimes it is hard to determine if the misalignment is in the learning objectives or in the activities or assessments. The course developer will be the best judge of what the solution will be. Your job is to point out the discrepancy and offer some constructive ideas. Here are some tips we have gathered from experienced QM reviewers to get you started. You might begin with a course tour and take a few notes before you begin your review. Remember to refer to the annotations in the workbook or in your packet and to what you see in the course. Focus on each standard individually. Your comments should only pertain to the standard at hand. And remember, there are many ways to meet a standard. While it's okay to make suggestions, if the required information is found in the course, even if it isn't where you would put it, the standard is considered met. Also, no course is perfect, so remember to think in terms of the 85% rule. And finally, all courses can meet QM expectations, and you are helping make that happen. As you can see, your expertise as a subject matter expert really counts. On behalf of the course developer, your dean, and the Office of Online Learning, a sincere thank you for your time and hard work.